Welcome back to myself playing God of War Ragnarok. Let's go to a bit more of a... That explains the healing before I go onto the boat. There we go again. Not so much of a heart attack as the first time. Rage up. Come on, let's stop the skater.
Look, over there.
So much for that boat.
Where's the other one? The other one died here. I don't use death much.
You know, an arrogant man once told me you can't change the past, only how it shapes you. I think he might be right. It's been a while since I had a confidant. Would the god of few words lend me his ear now and again?
As long as I am not.
Those scrawlings must be Sather nearby.
Ooh, is this the orb?
Lunda's orb.
Be cautious. We know not what it does.
You really think she'd send us to get the bloody thing if it was going to kill us? Let's just take it back to her.
I can make this spell. That is not a problem. I can hit that bell. How to do a delayed blast. That one. I can actually hit. Perhaps there's some kind of middle ground. All right. That is the key.
More Savor markings. Gulhild's companions can't be that far ahead. Look what they've done to this place.
That's all Lunda's armor taken care of, as well as her odd little spear. Should we return them to her?
Sigil arrows won't work on this.
Climb this wall. It'll go up.
Anything interesting, brother?
Over there, those are the lost Savor spirits, friends of Gulhild.
They don't look very friendly anymore, do they?
Let us put them to rest.
Let's get the treasure first.
Ha!
we done?
Not quite.
Protect yourself!
Where's your move, leaving me?
That's the last of them.
Damn it. I knew these souls. I would have thought them smarter than to meddle with sacred magic.
They were desperate.
And now they are dead. Good riddance.
You blame yourself.
And?
Do not lessen your pain.
Let's return to Gunhild. Unless you'd like to condescend more.
I do not.
Here's an artifact I wanted to pick up first.
Family crest of Kvasir the Wise. More like Kvasir the Inebriated, in truth.
It's passed through poison.
I wish things had gone differently, but these Saber are at rest. We'll have to find a way through this debris.
Above you! Watch out!
Okay.
Good thing you learned the runes, brother.
Treasure. It was an explosive, but where?
Sigil arrows won't work on this.
Go! know to blow that up. I need to get into space to do it. Try to be on the other side.
Left something behind.
Linda.
Right. Business time.
Yeah.
Oh, well, thank you so much. Elf has been itching to get her ball back all dang winter. It's her favorite toy.
What?
Good thing you are so cautious, brother.
Quiet.
He's right, Mimir. Show respect. The squeaky toy could have been the death of us all.
And it nearly was.
Somebody ought to not to please try. Even if the Vanir won't.
Okay.
Ready when you are. Damn! Am I good or what?
Very good.
Put some hurt on him. What's the Witch of the Woods need? Big man, you make up your mind. Hitting the road or chewing the fat?
Let's see, skills. interesting options. Let's desert. According to this, I'm right. Near the treasure. Treasure.
It is done.
Your friends are at peace.
Good.
And I'm sorry. Had I been here, I would have prevented this.
Do you think us lost babes, incapable of making our own choices?
No, but...
We made a mistake. But it was ours to make. Not yours to prevent. Even if you had been here.
I... Yes, you're right. Goodbye, Gunhil.
Goodbye, my
goddess. Kratos. Thank you for taking the time to help my people.
I helped no one. They were already dead.
Oh, but you did. You put their spirits at ease, and that has eased my spirit as well. I feel lifted.
Enjoy it. It will not last.
You're right. There are most certainly other corrupted sisters out in the realms.
You always know how to end on a cheery note, brother.
Well, let's continue around the river. Yeah.
Do you recall of the Aesir turning on Freya?
Oh, he certainly didn't deserve it. The Aesir were too undisciplined and impatient for the subtlety of Vanir spellcraft. So when things went wrong, they blamed their teacher.
So Freyr was a guest when Odin burned him?
Not exactly. Odin didn't mind locking Freyr up. He saw the potential of the magic and wanted to know more than how to improve crop yields. It was a mob of lesser Aesir, bitter and short-sighted, who tied him up and lit him aflame. As punishment for the sabotage they imagined him guilty of. Obviously, he survived. In fact, he used the opportunity to escape. But such an affront... No! All that thought, Alex is about to be violent.
Son of a spirit.
What is wrong?
Please, leave
me to my place. I await Freya, the great healer.
I am here.
She will kill me. I have been a loyal follower. She would not abandon.
I am Freya. What do you need?
Only she can cure my sickness. Mangold, Meyer, and Poe.
We must help her.
She demands a cure. She is dead.
She is trapped here, ignorant of her own death. If we bring her what she needs, she'll move on.
You're certain?
I'm not going to do nothing. She needs Mangold, Meyer, and Tom. We should find something. What did you find?
As you asked.
A nook and saw. Be wary.
Rot!
That nook is healing its friends, brother.
Where's the next one?
I could recall the face of every one of my people, but sometimes I wonder what gods must do now.
Everyone's felt the same.
Anything illuminating?
Useful.
Ah. And last but not least.
Looks like that worked. Well, that did it. That's everything I need. Let's return to the Sick Spirit.
You would cure the dead.
I promised I would take care of my people.
You do not even remember her. Nor she you.
And?
Let us return to the Spirit. Collected the plans.
Could this be? I feel my vitality returning to me. I feel Freya.
I am here.
I knew you would return. Even as the doubters cursed your name.
Thank you. But it's time to rest. You have earned it.
Thank you, my queen. I am tired indeed.
Shall we continue?
Yes.
Yes. One place that I haven't discovered yet.
To tell of Freya being burned by the Aesir mob.
Well, Freya certainly wasn't the same after that. At least for a while. His carefree ways were replaced with nightmares, paranoia, and lashing out.
We'll just pick this up later.
That, which we'll do in a second. I'd rather get my treasure first.
Oh!
Dunk. We can. Treasure. Now let's get more treasure. That wasn't a building I could get into. Those things most. I have to prepare a shop, okay. That's fine. That's there.
Despite his actions in Midgard, Atreus does still care for you.
I know. I raised a son, too. It may be hard to believe, but He was quite similar to Atreus at this age. He adored his father, always wanted to do right by him, and was constantly frustrated that no matter what he did, he never could seem to get his approval. He confided in me a lot, sought the comfort his father withheld. I wonder if your son could benefit from that too.
He has befriended the other dwarf, the Blue One's brother.
Oh. Well, if Sindri has that covered, I suppose there's no need for me in his life anymore, is there?
That is not what I meant.
That was sarcasm.
Freya, you were speaking of your brother after he was burned by the Aesir mob.
Yes. It haunted him for a long time. It doesn't excuse what he said at my wedding, but I do understand where his anger came from.
There's a lot to this river.
Freya, there's something I've always wanted to ask. What was it Hrimthor whispered to you?
Who?
Hrimthor, the son of Thormur, the stonemason, who disguised himself and built Asgard's wall.
Oh, yes. One of the many occasions Odin saw fit to involve me in a wager without my consent. I wish I could say that was the worst of his husbandly habits.
What wager?
I've told this story, brother.
And now she may tell her own.
There isn't that much to tell. I knew nothing of it at first, surely because Odin didn't expect to lose the bet. A mysterious mason had to build the entire wall in 3 turns of the season.
It was two!
And if he was late, he'd be owed nothing. But if he succeeded, he was promised an audience with the queen. Or so I learned one day when Odin burst into our bedchambers, raging and half-drunk before noon, telling me to get dressed and go see what the mason wants. So, off I went, not knowing what had truly been promised or expected. Dagger stashed in my robe for emergency. And this mason, this giant in disguise...
His name was Hrimthor!
He just smiled to see me, and as you said, he whispered in my ear. He said the Aesir had killed his father, and he needed to know that one day they'd burn for it. I pointed out I was Aesir now too, technically. He gave me a look, as if he somehow knew better, and continued. He said he'd built in a structural flaw behind the Asgard Realm Tower.
I knew it! How do we make use of it?
We don't. He said Surtur would know what to do. And if Surtur's approaching Asgard's wall...
Then it is already Ragnarok.
Ah, blast it. I hoped it might have given us another way.
I'll be honest, stop recording here before I go wherever this path leads me. If you watch this, thank you very much, and I'll catch you guys later. Bye.